Hi everyone, welcome to the Python tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to do the ballot counting. So I would have a list of the unordered votes. And from the votes, I would like to find out the winning candidates. And it is possible that there are two or more electors who have the same highest votes. So I would like to print out all the names of the winners, and in this demonstration, I would like to minimize my use of built-in functions. Let us see the implementation. The votes will be stored in the list, so the format can be like this. So this list called polls are storing the names collected when somebody is counting the votes. So the first vote received belongs to Ben, and the second vote belongs to Andy. Ben again, Andy again, and the fifth one is Carol, and the sixth one is Carol, something like that. Let me continue the list of the polls first. Yes, complete. So I have three candidates, Andy, Ben, and Carol. I would like to see who wins the election. It is possible that two or even three of them would have the same maximum votes. So how can I handle this situation? In my implementation, I will use a list called candidates to store the candidates received from this polls list. So when I receive some new candidates, I will put the name of that candidate into this candidate list. So for now, it is an empty string because we haven't known the candidates of this election. We have to really loop over the polls list in order to know that. I would like to create a list called votes, which is an empty list for now. And the votes list is going to store the number of votes obtained according to a certain candidate. So suppose Ben is the first element in the candidate's list, and then the the first element of this votes list will be the number of votes for Ben. If Andy is the second candidate in the candidates list, the second element of the votes list will correspond to the votes that would like Andy to win the election. So I would need to loop over every single element in the polls list in order to do the counting. Okay, here, if the person being inspected is not in the candidates list, it means that it is a new candidate in this election. Then I would like to put the name of that candidate into the candidates list. Okay, since that person is new to the candidates list, it is the same for the votes list. So the votes should also be a new one. So I would append one to the votes list. That means this person has at least one vote at the beginning. When a person is new to the candidates list, the votes corresponding to this candidate will be equal to one, which means it is the first time for the officials of the election to see the name of this candidate. If the person is already inside the candidate list, it means that this person is already appearing in the candidate list. It is no longer a new candidate. For example, when a person is looping over this band, it is no longer a new name that can be stored in the candidates list. So I will do something like this for this situation. Okay, candidate index is a variable name that stores the index for the person being looped. So if Ben is the third element in the polls list, which already appears in the candidates list already, then I would pick up the index for Ben in the candidates list, which is 0. In our case, so candidate index would be 0, which represents Ben, and vote 0 plus equals 1 means that I would add one more vote to the votes corresponding to the first element in the votes list, which corresponds to Ben. Okay, and then after this for loop, I would be able to save the candidates in the candidates list and the corresponding votes for each of those candidates appearing in the candidates list. Then I can do the real comparison to see the winner at this stage. I would like to initialize two variables first. Max vote refers to the number of votes that corresponds to the leading elector. And maximum candidates refers to a list that is going to store the names of the leaders. Okay. That may be two or more leaders in the election, because two or more of them can have the same highest vote. I have to do a for loop to help me find out the winners. This sentence means that I'm going to loop over the votes list. So if in our case we have three candidates, length of votes will become 3. So I would become 0, 1, and 2. If the votes is larger than the maximum vote, it means that it is the value of the leader's vote. Okay, so I would like to save the information corresponding to the leading candidate. Okay, here I'm going to store the maximum fold for the time being to the variable called max fold, and the corresponding candidate who is getting the highest fold for now will be stored in the candidate variable here. Okay. After I've got the single leader, I will do something like this. What does it mean by that? If there is a candidate I whose vote is larger than maximum vote, it means that that candidate I is the current leader. So I will erase the original max candidates list if it is storing some other electors in the list. So if this condition is satisfied, I'm able to determine the new leader. So I will save the new leader to the max candidates list. Before I save the new leader, I have to overwrite the original list that was storing the previous leader or leaders before I do the the new appending of the candidate. Okay. What about the situation if there is one more candidate who is getting the same highest vote? Let us handle the situation now. If there is another candidate who is also having the same maximum vote, that means there are currently two or more leaders. So what I'm going to do is that I would put that candidate name into the candidate variable, and I would put this variable to do the appending to the max candidates list. That means I will update the max candidates list to have one more candidate who is also leading in the election. So in this case, I have already handled the situation when there is a single leader for the time being, and when there are two or more leaders having the same highest vote. So after the whole for loop, the ballot counting is complete, and then I can print out the results like this. Here, I'm able to print out the leader or leaders who are already stored in the max candidate list. And then I can also print out the number of votes that the winner or winners have got. Something like this. Max vote refers to the number of votes for the winner or winners. So let us see the result if I use this pose to do the ballot counting. Oh, error. Let me check. Here, what's the problem? Oh, the indentation level doesn't match, so I have to match this small letter E with the small letter I on line 21. Same for the following two lines to make sure that the indentation of these two lines match that of the previous lines in the for loop. Okay, let me check again. Yes, I got it. We have five andes and five carols and three bends. So in this case, andy and carol all both get 5 folds. So in this case, I can print out andy and carol. And these two names are stored in the max candidates list after the ballot counting. And since I use the separator with a new line character, each of the elements in the max candidate list will be printed out one line by one line. And I can also print out the number of votes for both Andy and Carol. How about if I have one more Carol? When I run the code, yes, I will only have Carol. Carol will have the highest number of votes, which is 6. And in this case, this part will be executed because Carol will be the only leader of this election. So before this Carol is checked, Andy and Carol will have this same maximum vote. So at the time before this Carol is investigated, the max candidates originally were storing both Andy and Carol. But when this Carol is looped over in the votes list, the max candidates list will be erased with an empty list, and I can simply put Carol to the max candidates list as the only element in this list. So I can print only Carol as the winner of this election. My code is intuitive and straightforward, but it may not be the most efficient solution to the problem. If you can suggest any improvement of my code, please post your code on the comment section of this web page. And you can feel free to like my video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.